Triangle are similar. What are the methods you should do? What are the things you learn? Angle, right? So you need to show AA, right? You need to show two angles are the same. So are there two angles that are the same? So the 90 degree is the same. Another one? Yes. So over here, you see that this angle is so-called shared or common. Alright, use these two words. So the first pair of angle is the same is this and this. These two angles is the same, 90 and 90. The second angle is this is shared. Therefore, they are similar. Not midpoint. It's just that these two triangles, they have the same angle. Does it make sense to you? Yes. Okay. Now, 19B. Who? How do you put in words? Very simple. You just have to write down angle. Okay, let me just write down. Angle ADB is equal to angle ACE is equal to 90. This is given. So this is the first A, Matthew. Second A. Angle BAD is equal to angle CAE. Common. Or you can put shared. Optional. This is the second A. Because you show that two pair of angles are the same. Therefore, triangle ACE similar to triangle ADB. Bracket AA or AAA. Clear? Now in B, okay, now I want to do B. For B, they want to find area. So then it's the one that we learned just now, right? For similar triangle, area 1 over area 2 is equals to length 1 over length 2 square. Let's say this is the small one. Let's say this is the big one. Now let's start. What will you write? A1 is?
6.
How you know 6? ABD is a small triangle, so I don't know. So I write one. I will write down A1 over A2. A2 is a big triangle. Big triangle is 24. Can follow?
Yes.
What is L1? The small triangle. Can I use any random length? Or must I use the pairing? Must use both corresponding length. You understand the word corresponding? Yes. So which means if I were to use AC, what must I use? AB. Wrong. A. If I use AC, I must use what?
AD.
Yin Ting, I'm looking at this keyword. Triangle ACE, triangle ABD. If I use AC, I must use AD. Alright, so I hear wrongly. You said D just now. Square. Okay, I can also use another one. I can also use CE. If I use CE, I must use BD. If I use AE, then I must use AB. Which two lengths do I have? AB. And B. I have AB, right? AB is the big triangle, right? No, AB is a small triangle. So this one is 5. If I use AB, I must use AE. Do I have AE? You don't have it, then how to use? That's what I don't understand.
Sir, you can use half AB sin C, but you can find the Pythagoras theorem.
Oh, I can use Pythagoras theorem. Yeah, it's not only. Oh, this one is for the next one, is it?
C.
Okay, Okay, but you understand the concept, ah? Okay. So area of triangle is just half. You know the C, man? You did use Pythagoras theorem. If you use Pythagoras theorem, then don't need half AB sin C, it's just half base times height. Because sin 90. Okay. This is your one mark, Anyway, the concept I explained just now is to use C, right? So, this B, if I write that, can I stop already? All understand? Okay, then I can go to C. Then I want to find AE. Now, to find AE. Okay, now, so I continue with C. See who not sure. Okay, then after we talk about this nonsense. After we talk about this concept here, are you clearer? Still no ah? Don't know anything. No, if I have this concept. Yeah. Okay. So this concept and the A1 over A2 must come together. So I write down A1 over A2 is equal to length 1 over length 2 squared. Now, still this is small, this is big. The small triangle you found in B, that was 6. 6 over 24 is equals to, which two length do you want to use? You want AE. So you want AE means AE is here. AE correspond to what? AE is here, correspond to AB, right? So this is AB. But do you have AB? Oh, you have, then can do all? So clear about this?
Yeah.
Yes, huh? AB is 5. You go and calculate.